Good evening, and I'd like to first thank all of you for coming, and I thank Sri Prasanna and you and everybody else for having included me in what is a very, very important movement and what is a very important call. And this call is on behalf of so many artists, artisans, craftspeople, people in the textile industry, farmers, all of it. And I think it is very important that as much as possible all of us get involved in something that matters to every one of us. It is not something that is far away from our lives, it is intimate to our lives. I'll just share a few thoughts with you before I start singing. I'd like to first talk about this idea of knowledge. And I think somewhere it is at the basis of the way you behave in society and the way you treat certain things in society vis-a-vis certain other things in society. We never see the work of a farmer or an artisan or a craftsperson or a textile person as a way of creating knowledge. Knowledge has been boxed in a certain market-driven idea of what it contributes to society. And since we are not able to see that knowledge of living, knowledge of being, knowledge of textile, knowledge of making things that you make every day is actually the most intrinsic human way of creating knowledge. Because it is about the body, the mind, the environment. It is about our association with being human beings. So whether it's the food that we eat, or whether it's the clothes that we wear, or whether it is where we travel, all these things are part of the way we create knowledge. We can't reduce knowledge to be an empirical data on a computer screen or on a textbook. And knowledge cannot be reduced to what mainstream society determines as intelligence. And I think one of the primary reasons why we don't care enough, we don't care at all about people who create knowledge every day, not because they have to display to you, because that is how they live. It's because we don't value what they are creating as being intrinsic to what we are as people and civilization. What we use another word, and that word is labor. Knowledge and labor are, we have separated knowledge and labor. That we consider labor to us does not create knowledge. And that which creates knowledge is not labor. It is something superior. And because we have decided that those things that create knowledge are superior, we have attached certain things to that. I am speaking the word of art itself. Because recently I was having a conversation with an artist who performs an art form called Kutil. And it is an art form practiced by the communities in different parts of the world. We observe it is similar to Yakshagana in form, but not in terms of communities and so on. And they always call their art regular or labor. But I, as a classical musician, will never call my art labor. I will call my art jnana, wisdom. And in this differentiation is how we differentiate human beings, arts, crafts, agriculture, vis-a-vis what other things we value. And so when we all gather here to galvanize support, galvanize thinking, galvanize activism towards addressing this GST issue, this cannot start and end with the GST issue. There has to be a systemic change in the way we look at people, look at how they function, look at what they create. And unless we do that, there will be another hurdle to this system. And is music handmade? That's a kind of almost a philosophical question. Because I can always tell you that Jira is handmade, the violin is handmade, the organ is handmade. So those are very literal things. I think if you look at what is the handmade, if their document is a beautiful definition of what handmade is. The most important thing about the idea of the handmade is that in every unit, in every second, in every piece or every element that is created, the human being is constantly conscious of that creation and the interaction with that creation. This is exactly what music should be. Every product you buy which is handmade is a personal creation of individuals living in the world. It could have not been outsourced to a machine to produce it. The person's own being exists in that. When the mridangam is made by the mridangam maker, every mridangam is individual. Every mridangam is different. Every time the steel is chosen, it is chosen differently. And every time Jaisalmer plays, it is the creation of that moment. And one very important aspect of this, in this world where we seem to think of replication, and another very famous word is scaling. Scaling and replication is the only way we are deciding that our society gets survived. This extends from the corporate world to the social world. Because even in the social sphere, if you want money, you have to tell the corporate how you can scale it. Only in the corporate sense, it's giving you money. Sorry, scale, not okay. But you go to any CSR person, they will tell you the same thing. Handmade is not about scaling. Handmade is a philosophy of the opposite. It is a philosophy of being the individual. It is a philosophy of being independent. And handmade is about independence. And if you look at the privacy verdict that was just declared by the Supreme Court a month ago, handmade is at the spirit of that privacy verdict. The right to be who you are, the right to feel what you feel, the right to make what you make, the right to create what you do, and right to basically live as a citizen of this country and be valued as a citizen of this country because you are. And that value as a citizen of this country is an essential part. And I think music is also very similar to exactly that. And finally, I want to talk about one more point that I mean is the idea of livelihood. Livelihood, what is livelihood? Livelihood, I think that it's essential, yes, it is about money coming into your work. But money can come in so many ways. For example, if you, this is the community that I know something about, it's like the fish folk community. Now, big companies come in, their jobs are changed, different occupation is there, but the river is destroyed, the shore is destroyed, the fish is destroyed, the health is destroyed. So, what has happened to livelihood? Livelihood is not just about what is coming in money, but it's also about the way of living. Livelihood is about the spirit of living, and money is a part of the spirit of livelihood. Which is why you have people even in poverty doing beautiful things across society. Why would anybody still be doing things that don't make them money like it makes me or anybody else? Because it is living. Livelihood is a way of living. Livelihood is a way of interacting with oneself. Livelihood is a way of interacting with the environment, with nature, with everything that around us. And unless we are able to see livelihood in a holistic sense of it being essential to the independence of the individual, giving a larger check does not transform livelihood, not always. So what we need to do is not bemoan the extinction of something or say we have lost something, but make sure that there are multiple livelihoods in this country. How do we do that? We do that to make sure that it is financially sustainable to live different lives. We can't all of us live lives one way, and we seem to want all of us to live very one way. We need people to live differently. We need people to live in the way that they live, which means we need to find ways by which we can economically create multiple spheres of livelihood and sustainability. And which is why this demand for zero GST is an essential demand for multiple people who work as individuals, as cooperatives, as self-help groups across this country. Many times when we raise the GST issue, people are only thinking of boutique shops in cities. This is not about boutique shops in cities. This is about people who are doing the work in the towns, in the villages, in the cities, and who work with the limited means that are available to create beautiful things. And beautiful not because they are visually beautiful, beautiful because they enrich the way we all live. So my only request to all of you is to please gather together to force the government to make a change with this GST policy. This is about the way we live. And like I said before, we keep talking about culture in this country. I don't know what culture we can talk about when we don't believe every beautiful culture in this country is about these beautiful people living life the way they live and creating things that enrich the way we can live. And this GST, removing this GST, is at the very basic thing that we can do in an environment where we have outsourced our mind, outsourced our spirit, and outsourced our sense of living to what you could call mechanized, machine-made ways of living. And it is, I can just say that it's an honor for me to participate in a movement that is working so hard to not only help so many lives of people, but also change the way society thinks. Thank you very much for coming.
Thank you very much, Krishna. Such a wonderful, broad, in-depth understanding of human life and handmade products, art, culture, heritage in the world. Thank you very much. If anyone of you have questions, you can raise and Krishna will answer.
Hundreds of years, but now one, and they had there is a, you know, for the raw materials there is a lot of this thing, the pricing they have to keep in mind, plus the availability of the raw materials, and also the infrastructure, whatever they have, you know, if they work in what you call as kugramas, where there is no proper electricity. So, you know, keeping all these things in mind, they had to keep the prices also low. We were talking about scaling. So, they just can't produce 50,000 saris, Kanjivarams or army saris. So, keeping all this in mind, I just want to add that we need to support the GST. Thank you.
No questions? Okay. Now I request Prasanna to speak briefly on all these issues.
No, I won't speak and come in the way of good music. I just have a small responsibility. Krishna has been very graceful. He is not taking a pie from us, but there are expenses. So our Grama Seva Sangh activism will come to you. Please donate whatever little you can, because we want every program to become self-sufficient. We don't want to ask sponsors to help this program. That's one thing. The second thing is, I think there is a need to clarify what we have been asking the government as far as that question was concerned. We are asking the government that the limit be made 50 lakhs. And beyond 50 lakhs, if the poor hand-working person makes themselves, federate themselves into an organization and become something like Amul or Vijay Papad or Desi or Taskarandra, then they should be able to go and compete in the city retail market, even if it is 10,000 crores. And when they do that, they should get zero tax as opposed to the other traders who are selling other products. This is the demand, and that demand I think is the right demand, because you have to provide them a level playing field. There is no level playing field for the hand working person, and what we are asking is only a level playing field. Thank you very much. Over to you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you. Some of them are not.